Hi, I'm Antonio with VitaHelix. Today, I'll give you my inputs on the third human clinical trial of nicotinamide mononucleotide NMN, just published in the Journal of the International Society of Sports Nutrition on July 8, 2021. Here we have the third NMN human clinical trial to confirm if the health exercise capacity benefits observed in mice supplemented with NMN can be translated to human. This study investigates the effects of combining exercise training and NMN supplementation on cardiovascular fitness in healthy amateur runners. This is a great news for me and for those who are considering take NMN to improve exercise performance. But first, if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to be updated with dietary supplement backed by science. Let's get into it. This study is a 6-week randomized double-blind placebo-controlled 4-arms clinical trial including 48 healthy participants, 40 males and 8 females, aged 27 to 50. All participants have a regular exercise routine for 1 to 5 years. The participants were randomized into 4 groups. As you can see in table 1, the control group has a placebo, low doses with 300 mg, medium groups with 600 mg, and high dose 1200 mg daily of NMN supplementation. Each group had 10 males and 2 females. The baseline characteristics such as BMI, body fat, and maximum oxygen consumption, VO2 max, were established. The NMN was orally administered by powder twice a day, at breakfast and lunch before training for 6 weeks. Each participant conduct 5 to 6 times per week aerobic exercise, including running and cycling, with a single training section lasting for 40 to 60 minutes. After 6 weeks of treatment, cardiopulmonary exercise testing, CPET, was performed to assess the aerobic capacity for the runners. The measurement was done by using a stationary bike, not the treadmill in this study. Okay, here's a summary of the results. First, exercise with NMN supplementation did not change body composition, including body mass, BMI, free fat mass, body fat percentage, as you can see in table 2. Here goes my thought. This is really expected since all the participants have a good BMI and body fat percentage as reported. In this case, there is no much room for BMI and body fat to be improved. And it's worthy to mention that we can't compare this data with the mice study, where the mice have a high adipose fat content. Second, exercise with NMN supplementation enhances ventilatory threshold and power at VT1 and VT2. For your information, the ventilatory threshold VT represents a level of intensity where blood lactate accumulates faster than it can be cleared, which causes the person to breathe faster to blow off the excess of CO2 produced by the buffering of acid metabolites. How do you know your ventilatory threshold? Just run an experiment measuring your oxygen consumption by increasing exercise intensity versus the amount of air breathed per minute. Then you can get these values and plot a graph. The first ventilatory threshold, VT1, is the point at the first inflection, and the VT2 is at the second inflection on the same graph. Okay, let's go back to the paper. The results from this study revealed that 6 weeks of endurance exercise combined with NMN supplementation in amateur runners enhanced the oxygen consumption, VO2, percentage of maximum oxygen uptake, VO2 max, as you can see in table 3. In addition, power at the first ventilatory threshold, VT1, and power at the second ventilatory threshold, VT2, increased to a higher degree in the median and higher dose groups compared with the placebo, as you can see in table 4. Compared to the exercise alone, the results indicate that NMN supplementation increases the ventilatory threshold due to an improved ability of oxygen utilization by the skeletal muscles. No added effect on cardio function was observed. Third, improvement of aerobic exercise capacity is dose dependent. Just for information, a human dose is about 1/10 compared to a mouse. Therefore, 50, 100, and 200 mg per kilogram a day of NMN for mice is approximately 300, 600, 1200 mg per kilogram a day for a human, if this human have 60 kg weight, body weight. Unlike the results observed in mice, a larger dose of NMN had better effect on improving the ventilatory threshold. No effect on physical function such as grip strength, push-up, or sit and reach was found. However, a daily dose of 600 mg and 1200 mg of NMN significantly improved the single leg stance test. So, what are the take-home message? If you remember the first NMN clinical trial in 10 health men only proved that in humans a single oral dose from 100 to 500 mg is safe. This study showed it is safe to take 300 to 1200 mg per day for 6 weeks without any adverse effects or abnormal ECG. Aerobic exercise along with NMN supplementation improved the ventilatory threshold, even in healthy young males and females. Improvement of aerobic capacity is dose dependent. The bigger, the better. The improvement is related to skeletal muscle. If you recall from the second clinical trial, NMN did increase NAD metabolites in the skeletal muscles. So for me, it makes sense. The improvement of the aerobic capacity in this clinical trial may come from the skeletal muscle. Coincidentally, I take 300 mg of NMN 30 minutes prior my treadmill exercise and another 300 mg at the midpoint of my 1 hour running. So total 600 mg daily. And I did feel much energized and I can breathe much better as well when I'm doing the exercise. The results may not be what you expect, but we may all appreciate the time and dedication of the researchers to bring us one more piece of the NMN puzzle in humans. I hope you like this video. As always, stay healthy and live longer.